فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
He says باب ابن خزيمة رحمه الله, he says باب ذكر إثبات الرجل لله عز وجل وإن رغمت أنوف المعطلة الجهمية. He says باب, the chapter mentioning of or affirming a leg for Allah تبارك وتعالى. وإن رغمت أنوف المعطلة الجهمية, even if the nose of the Jahmiyyah become dusted, the mu'attila, those who reject Allah's characteristics and attributes, الَّذِينَ those يُكَفِّرُونَ بِصِفَاتِ خَالِقِنَا, who disbelieve in Allah's characteristics عز وجل, الَّتِي أَثْبَتَهَا لِنَفْسِهِ, that which Allah affirmed for himself, فِي مُحْكَمِ تَنْزِيلِهِ, in his book, you see, وَعَلَى لِسَانِ نَبِيِّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ, on the tongue of his messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية رحمه الله, he took the path of the أئمة that were before him. You see, and what did he do? بوّب الشيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية في عقيدة الواسطية, in his book عقيدة الواسطية, he chapter a bab, and this is the bab he called it إثبات الرجل والقدم لله سبحانه وتعالى في سنة المطهرة. He brought a chapter and he says affirming for Allah a leg or a foot from the prophetic, the pure prophetic sunnah. And then he started to bring وساق الحديث, and he started to bring the chain of hadith. And I advise every talib al-ilm to go and look at this explanation of al-Shaykh Muhammad ibn Salih al-Uthaymeen on that chapter. You'll find a lot of fawaid, inshaAllah ta'ala. Al-Hafidh ibn Hajar al-Asqalani in Fath al-Bari, Hafidh ibn Hajar al-Asqalani rahimahullah, in Al-Fath al-Bari rahimahullah, he says, واختلف في المراد بالقدم. It has been disputed in the intent by the word al-qadam. It's been disputed what it means. There's a khilaf. The khilaf he's talking about is the khalaf, not the salaf. Because look what he says after that. Aimatu salaf did not differ upon this. They already knew what it meant. He's going to tell you what it means. Are you with me, brothers? What is it? فَطَرِيقُ السَّلَفِ, the tariqah of the salaf was what? في هذا, pertaining to Allah's foot. وغيره, and also other characteristics of Allah. The path of the salaf is مشهورةٌ, it is well known, it's well documented. Their stances regarding Allah's attributes and Allah's characteristics. Whether it be this characteristics, al-qadam, or whether it be any other characteristics, it's very, very well known their position, which is what? وهو أن تمر كما جاءت. It's to go over it as it has come. What is it? To go over it as it has come. This issue, this particular issue, أمروها كما جاءت. I want to stop over it a bit. لأن الشيخ ابن حافظ ابن حجر mentioned a powerful statement here right now, which is طريق السلف, when it comes to Allah's characteristics, he says their position is very well known. أليس كذلك? It's very well known, he said. صحيح, it's known. The khilaf that he mentions before is not salaf, is khalaf. And he's going to bring it later, inshallah ta'ala, the views that they have taken regarding it. أما سلف هذه الأمة, their position was clear from the get-go. What was their position? أن تمر كما جاءت, you go over these characteristics as they have come. What does it mean to go over it as it has come? And there are some people who use this as an argument to say تفويض المعنى. تفويض المعنى, here it is. سلف هذه الأمة, what they used to do was تفويض, meaning go over it, go over it. أمروها كما جاءت, to go over it as it is means say الله أعلم, I don't know what it means. And that is not the reality of it. That is not the reality. If you go to Kitab Abu Bakr al-Khalal, Kitab al-Sunnah, are you with me, brothers? He brings a statement of Imam al-Awza'i rahimahullah, and a statement of Imam Makhul and al-Zuhri, that they all said أَمِرُّوهَا كَمَا جَاءَتْ. And also, Al-Walid ibn Muslim, he said, I asked Malik ibn Anas, Sufyan al-Thawriyu, Layth ibn Sa'ad, Awza'iyu, all of them, I asked them, عَنِ الْأَخْبَارِ الَّتِي جَاءَتْ فِي الصِّفَاتِ. Pay attention. Al-Walid ibn Muslim is saying, I asked Al-Imam Malik ibn Anas, and Sufyan al-Thawriyu, Layth ibn Sa'ad, Al-Awza'i, I asked all of them, عن الأخبار التي جاءت في الصفات, all of the narrations that have come pertaining to Allah's characteristics and attributes, I asked. فقالوا, they said, all of them said, أمروها كما جاءت, go over them as they have come. وفي رواية, وفي رواية, وفي رواية, وفي رواية, and in a narration, قالوا, they said, أمروها كما جاءت, go over it as it has come, بلا كيف, without a how. Don't try to give it a how. Don't try to give it a كيفية. Now, if you look at أمروها كما جاءت, that's a رد على المعطلة. Are you with me, brothers? أمروها كما جاءت is a رد على المعطلة. As Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah mentions in his Al-Hamawiyyah. Is a refutation of who? The Mu'attila. Bila kayfina is a refutation on what? Al-Mumathila. The people who do tamthil of Allah's characteristics. Are you with me, brothers? And this statement, of course, as I said to you, Imam Malik said it, Sufyan al-Thawri said it, Layth ibn Sa'ad said it, Awza'i said it, also Hamad ibn Zayd, Hamad ibn Salama, and all of them. These a'immah to dunya of their time. They were the a'immah of their time. But let's ponder here. أَمِرُّوهَا كَمَا جَاءَتْ بِلَا كَيْفٍ. And this is something Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah alerted us to and brought to our attention. Powerful point. And that is, أَمِرُّوهَا كَمَا جَاءَتْ is like the statement of Imam Malik before. And the athar of the Salaf, rahimahumullah, and what they said, if you bring them all together, you will have a better understanding. And Imam Malik, rahimahullah, a very famous statement of his, and also it's attributed to Rabi'at al-Ra'i, rahimahullah ta'ala, the Shaykh of Imam Malik, Imam Malik's teacher, that they both said, Al-Istiwa غير مجهول. The Istiwa is not unknown to us. والكيف غير معقول. And the how is not something we have comprehended. والإيمان به واجب. And believing it is what? Obligatory. That statement is exactly أَمِرُّوهَا كَمَا جَاءَتْ بِلَا كَيْفٍ. They go hand in hand. Look what the Salaf negated here. بارك الله فيكم. What is it that the Salaf negated? نَفُوا عِلْمَ الْكَيْفِيَّةِ. They negated the knowledge of the how. Look what they said. الْإِسْتِوَاءُ غَيْرُ مَجْهُولٍ وَالْكَيْفُ غَيْرُ مَعْقُولٍ. The كَيْف is unknown to us. So what did they negate? They negated, no, pay attention. They didn't negate the how. Don't say that. That's wrong. Allah has a how in his characteristics. They negated the knowledge of the how. We don't know it. Oh. But why didn't they negate haqiqatu sifa, the reality of the characteristics? Why didn't they say, we also don't know the characteristics as well? You with me, brother? This is powerful. Rather, the fact that they said, amirruha, go over it, bila kayfin, means, and it can't have any other meaning, as Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah said, is because once I give you what the meaning is, and once the meaning is known, don't get fooled and start to compare it with other characters, compare it with the creation, or give it a how. Now that you know the meaning of what istiwa means, don't try to compare that characteristics to the one of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. You see? So bila kayfin comes بعد إثبات حقيقة الصفة. After you've affirmed the reality of the characteristics, then and only then can I then say to you, بلا كيف, without a how. But if you've negated أصل الصفة, the original essence of the characteristics, بلا كيف, saying it is what? Is without a purpose. It has no meaning to it. Rather, and Imam Malik رحمه الله, what did he say? الاستواء غير مجهول. استواء is not unknown to us. We know it. In another riwayat, some of the, what does it say? Al-istiwa'u ma'lum. Istiwa is ma'lum to us. Is well known to us. So Imam Malik rahimahullah ta'ala is saying, we know what istiwa means. We know it in what way? في اللغة, في لغة العرب, is known al-istiwa'u ala wartafa, that is high and it's above. Referring to the statement of Abu Aliya rahimahullah ta'ala, who mentions that it is, you see. So Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah here, he elaborates on that point. Go to his Hamawiyyah. Also go to his Majmu' al-Fatawa, the fifth volume, page 39 to page 42. You'll find a fawaid benefits from there. You'll find a lot of very powerful statements. Ibn al-Qayyim in his Madarij al-Salikin, very beneficial points that he brings. So I think that statement of Imam al-Hafidh ibn Hajar, the reason why I went off topic here right now is to mention that when Hafidh ibn Hajar said, واختلف في المراد بالقدم فطريقة السلف في هذا وغيره مشهورة وهو أن تمر كما جاءت. You know what it means, تمر كما جاءت. It means go over it without a how. Affirm the meaning in it, but don't try to go deep into the how. Don't try to have the desire to do that. You see, go over it like that. And he himself, look at this, Allahu Akbar. Hafiz ibn Hajar, بلسانه, his own tongue, he says the following. He says, واختلف في المراد بالقدر فطريقة السلف في هذا وغيره مشهورة وهو أن تمر كما جاءت ولا يتعرض لتأويله. And that the person does not indulge in the distortion of these characteristics. ولا يتعرض لتأويله. Don't do تأويل of it. هذا طريقة السلف. بل نعتقد استحالة ما يوهم النقص على الله. Rather, what we believe is that the impossibility of any deficiency that would be attributed to Allah's characteristics, or any deficiency that would basically be connected to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, that Allah is not deficient in any way, form or shape, that we believe that's impossible. Al-Imam Abu Ubaid Qasim al-Sallam, as Al-Imam al-Bayhaqi brings in his kitab الأسماء والصفات. That الإمام أبو عبيد قاسم السلام مدري سي. نحن we نروي هذه الأحاديث. We will narrate these أحاديث. ولا نزيغ لها المعاني. And we will not also deviate for it a meaning. We won't start to play around with these words and just start making up meanings for it. أبدا. And place meanings in it as we go by. And we're going to see that later. How they try to distort this characteristic of Qadam. Al-Imam Yahya ibn Ma'in. Al-Imam Yahya ibn Ma'in, the great Imam that we know, he said, Shahadtu Zakariya ibn Adin Sa'ala Waki'an. Yahya ibn Ma'in said, I was present. Okay? Zakariya ibn Adi asking Waki' ibn Jarrah al-Ru'asi. He was asking him. Faqala, he said to him, Zakariya ibn Adi said to Waki'. يا أبا سفيان أو أبو سفيان هذه الأحاديث all these أحاديث referring to the hadith of الكرسي موضع القدمين that the كرسي is the position is the statement of Ibn Abbas that the كرسي is the place of Allah for Allah's foot سبحانه وتعالى and others like that these characters these أحاديث what do we do with it? وكيع responded by saying أدركنا إسماعيل من أبي خالد وسفيان ومسعرا we met إسماعيل من أبي خالد and also سفيان and also مسعرا all of them يحدثون بهذه الأحاديث they were all narrating these أحاديث ولا يفسرون شيئا and they will not give it meanings from their anfusihim, from their own selves. Very good. That is in terms of the a'immatu salaf, rahimahumullahu jami'an, what they said regarding this characteristic of Allah. Now, what have the rest said about this? And where did they go wrong regarding this? So we're now going to falsify the argument of those who try to distort these characteristics by giving it false meanings. By giving it false meanings. Hafiz ibn Hajar in Fathul Bari, and this is inshallah his statement, he brings these, after he brings the qawl of this A'imah to Salaf, and we just mentioned it right now, sah? Hafiz ibn Hajar mentions the tariqah to Salaf and their path methodology. That they believed what? أَمِرُّهَا كَمَا جَاءَتْ بِلَا كَيْفٍ That was madhhab al-salaf and their methodology in this particular issue. Very good. Hafiz then brings the opinion of others. and their position. Now, some of them is what? The following. There are about five, six views regarding what the word qadr means. Hafidh ibn Hajar said, وَقَادَ كَثِيرٌ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْعِلْمِ فِي تَأْوِيلِ ذَلِكَ. He said, a lot of people, of scholars and people of knowledge, they indulged in the meaning and the interpretation of what the characteristics means. Qadam, what it means. The first opinion that was put forward, which is Al-Muradu Idlalu Jahannam. Allah is humiliating Jahannam. فإنها إذا بالغت, because if Jahannam has reached في الطغيان in its transgression and it is requesting extra to be added onto it, أذلها الله, الله تبارك وتعالى, he humiliates it. فوضعها تحت القدم, and Allah places it under the foot. وليس المراد حقيقة القدم, and this is not the reality, this is not the literal meaning of the word قدم. It means Allah just belittles it. You know, when you belittle somebody, you say, Akhi, you just put me under the foot, man. Yeah? So it's basically idlalu jahannam. It just means Allah is humiliating jahannam. Does that make sense? That's the first group. The second opinion that was suggested, or interpretation that was put forward, was that what is meant by it is those who Allah has put forward. The word qadr means here, Allah is going to place in Jahannam those who He has what? He has qaddamahu, He's put forward. Min ahli al-adab, from the people of punishment. In the Quran, do we not say that? بِمَا قَدَّمَتْ أَيْدِيهِمْ. That's what your hand put forward. The third is that the word qadam here is some of the creations of Allah. It's a group of from the creation of Allah. So they're the ones that are going to be thrown into there. Another opinion is that there's an actual creation whose name is, there's a particular individual whose name is called qadam. There's a makhluq, a creation, whose name is called qadam. Another opinion is that the word al-qadam is the last. Just like the foot. Are you with me? The Arabs, what do they say? The qadamu shay, akhiru shay, that's what they mean. The last of things. So it means Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is going to place in the hellfire the last of its people. Good. Also from those who went, and Hafidh ibn Hajar refuted him as well, is Ibn Furak. Hafidh refuted him, which is that he said that the lafdhul rijl, the rijl, the leg, that wording, غَيْرُ ثَابِتَةٍ عِنْدَ أَهْلِ النَّقْلِ. Ibn Furak, who is not known for ilm al-hadith, even though he's the teacher of Imam al-Bayhaqi, and Bayhaqi didn't take ilm al-hadith from him, but he took from Ibn Furak was ilm al-kalam. He was from the mutakallimin. So he speaks about a field that he doesn't know. And he goes on to saying that this wording, الرِّجْلُ غَيْرُ ثَابِتَةٍ عِنْدَ أَهْلِ النَّقْلِ, it is not affirmed and it is not transmitted correctly according to the scholars of hadith. Hafidh ibn Hajar says, وَهُوَ مَرْدُودٌ لِثُبُوتِهَا. That is a rejected and a refuted argument because it's present فِي الصَّحِحَيْنِ Bukhari and Muslim. We find the wording al-rijlu, that wording in Sahihain, Bukhari and Muslim. So that argument is very weak. And this is how these mutakallimeen, that's how they were towards the ahadith of the Messenger, alayhi salatu wasalam, their ignorance. Ahadith that are in Bukhari and Muslim, they was rejected. Or they wouldn't even affirm it. Huh? But that, the Saqqaf that I spoke to about, Hasan al-Saqqaf, hadahullah. What did he do? He goes, if we find in Bukhari and Muslim, then Allah tabarak wa ta'ala has a qadam and a rijl, he said, I won't take it. We won't take it. So If you want to take what's in Bukhari and what's in Muslim, then what are you going to take?
Huh?
What are you going to take? That's where the desire takes you to the end. Wallah, it'll push you and it'll push you, it'll push you, it'll take you to that point. Like the man who said, if I hear my teacher, I think he said, if I hear A'mash narrate this hadith, he said, I won't take it. And if A'mash narrates from his teacher, I won't take it. You see, it was a mubtadi' khabith. And he goes, he says, until he goes to the Prophet, he said, if the Prophet said, I want to take it from him. He said, even if Allah says, I want to take it from him. If Allah says it, hatta I will question Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. And that's how their methodology was like. These arguments, they've all been responded for. They've all been responded to. Because Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, in his noble book, Al-Fatawa al-Misriyah, Al-Fatawa al-Misriyah, when the i'tiradat was brought forward to him, the Shaykh, rahimahullah ta'ala, he responded. So he responds to those who say what the meaning of the word rijl means. Some argue that they said rijl, it means in the Arabic language, rijlun min al-jaradi, the Arabs use it, rijlun min jarad, ta'ifatun min jarad. So the word rijl in the Arabic is ta'ifa, a group. In the Arabic language, that's what they said. So they said that's what it means. Good. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah says, he responded by saying, the reason why those arguments, all of them, don't make sense is because Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he says, hatta yada, until he places. And he didn't, sorry, so the Prophet ﷺ said, hatta yada. He didn't say, hatta yalqa, hatta yulqa. Are you with me? It's powerful, this statement. What does our one say? He says what? لا يلقى في النار وتقول هل من مزيد حتى يضع. Until Allah تبارك وتعالى places, and not until he throws in. لأن يلقى, it means that's a creation now that can be used. يضع is you're placing something in there. That gives it a total meaning. Look at what Allah used. Are you with me? Pay attention. When he was talking about the creation, what did he say? La yazalu yulqa fiha. At the beginning, this one narration, the other narration says la yazalu, which we're going to come to. But this one says yulqa fi nari, a people will be thrown to the hellfire. So this is a creation. You're taking them, you're throwing them. That's the creation. But then when it came to his foot, what did he say? Hatta yada'a rijlahu. He didn't say hatta yalqa rijlahu. Because if he said hatta yalqa, then we can say, there's a discussion open here now. Because Allah is placing a creation in there. Sahih? That argument has no basis. Also, the statement of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, qadamahu. Are you with me? Qadamahu. If we say that the qadam here is a type of the creation. Are you with me? Are you with me, brothers? Then that would mean Allah attributed this creation to himself. Because the dhamir goes back to the creation, right? Hatta yada'a qadamahu, until Allah places his foot. Qadamahu. So if we say hatta yada'a, until Allah places a group into the hellfire, that the fact that Allah brings them back to him. Because if we say qadamahu, it means naw'un min al-khalqi. It means khalqahu, his creation. Sahih? And the fact that Allah attributed the creation to him is not min al-tashrif, honoring them. Are you with me? When you say baytullahi, for example, the house of Allah. Naqatullahi, Allah is naqa. There's a not min al-tashrif. So if Allah is honoring them, then why is he throwing them into the hellfire for? Sahih? So according to that, لا حقيقة ولا مجاز, لا, it doesn't, لا يستقيم. And to say that they're the first or the last, are you with me? The siyaq of the hadith doesn't allow that. Because what does it say? لا يزال يلقى, the people will be thrown in there, حتى يضع رجله. That shows you that the pouring in, the people that are being poured into the hellfire had to come to an end. Because Allah said, I did this until he placed his foot in there. Meaning the creation finished. The creation finished. It wouldn't make sense to say, حتى للغاية. The حتى shows غاية. It wouldn't make sense to say, I was throwing creation in there until I threw a creation in there. لا يستقيم. It doesn't make sense. لا يستقيم. It doesn't make sense. Yani Allah had to do something else to make Jahannam full. So my beloved brother and sister, Shaykh Ibn Uthaymeen, as I said to you, if you go to his Sharh Aqidat al-Wasitiyya, I'm doing a Dar Ibn al-Jawzi, his Mu'assas al-Khayriya, go to the second volume, page 452. Shaykh Ibn Uthaymeen, he does also responds. Also, if you go to the Al-Fatawa al-Misriya by Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Uthaymeen, he also responds to these arguments and these points that these individuals brought forward. And I think that inshallah ta'ala gives us a good understanding that these characteristics is the characteristics of Allah. Ithbatun, we affirm it. Bila ta'atilin, we affirm these characteristics of Allah without any ta'atil. Wa tanzihun, and we also negate from him. Bila, ithbatun bila tamthilin, wa tanzihun bila ta'atilin, that was it. We affirm ithbatun, we affirm for Allah these characteristics, bila tamthilin, without resembling to his creations. Wa tanzihun, we negate from Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Bila, without ta'atil. So inshallah ta'ala, we're going to conclude there, bi'idhnillahi, for today's class. Subhanaka Allahumma bihamdik, ashadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.